36.9 degrees Celsius is our ideal internal temperature, regulated by the hypothalamus at the base of the brain and sensors across the skin. But as core temperatures rise, thermoregulation turns to acute self-preservation that leaves the body vulnerable in many ways. A common reaction to a rise in temperature is the hypothalamus triggers sweat production, cooling the body as it evaporates. The more the ambient temperature and humidity increases, though, the less effective this transfer of heat is. Blood vessels will dilate, which in turn makes the heart beat faster and generates more internal heat. The body can quickly become overwhelmed. Even a rise of 0.1 degree can cause heat exhaustion, according to the American Family Physician Journal. At this point, it's key to find shade, properly hydrate, and reassess after 20 to 30 minutes. Heat exhaustion evolves to heat stroke above a core temperature of 40 degrees Celsius, and the body enters multi-system failure. A telltale sign is central nervous system dysfunctions like delirium, convulsions, comas, and even seizures. The hypothalamus will slow activity of the non-essential organs, such as the gastrointestinal tract and kidneys, to preserve respiratory and cognitive functions. But with lower blood and oxygen flow, all these organs are susceptible to damage. Cell death can also occur. The cerebellum is one of the first parts of the brain affected, which in turn inhibits motor functions. When the heart is ready to give up, it will slow down and stop beating. Hypothermia is driving these failures, and the AFP journal recommends rapid cooling of the body. External methods include evaporative cooling, when a mist of cool water is sprayed on the skin while warm air is fanned over the body, and immersive cooling in an ice bath or cooling blankets paired with ice packs on the armpits, groin, neck, and head areas. Internal cooling methods are even more effective. Irrigating the gastric, bladder, and rectal cavities with fluid can be accomplished with minimal invasion by trained medical staff. Heatstroke is an emergency, and the mortality rate can approach 10%. But when appropriate treatment is provided without delay, survival can approach 100%.